Whew. And last one for tonight. I want to talk to you about the fallacy of seed, faith, giving. Because the crazy part is you don't never see seed faith in the Bible. But why is it seed faith giving always have a dollar amount? Because when you look at the Old Testament, in the Old Testament, the priests were in the temple and they were supposed to get a portion of the sacrifice that you brought. And that was for the maintenance of the priests and the maintenance of the temple so that you can offer it up to God. But even then, the priests started to get ratchet. Look at the sons of Eli. So I'm telling you right now, man, they will give you seed faith, but they will not cultivate you enough to empower you to get out here to have prosperity. Because the crazy thing is, you can sow faith, but what is faith? What is you sowing seeds without no type of cultivation? And that's the God knows truth. Because the thing about farming is that, number one, you got to cultivate throughout the process. Cultivate the land before you plant the seed. And even when you plant the seed, you still cultivate. You got to water it. But this seed faith thing, it's a one-time action. You're giving your money, but you ain't getting jack. He done got his harvest. She done got her harvest. But what are you getting? You're waiting for something that's not going to grow because, number one, you ain't getting no seed and you ain't cultivating it. You're not watering it. So there is a beginning, a middle, and an end. But the one thing that I want you to understand is that seed faith given is not in the Bible. And a lot of you, it's the pyramid scam. It's the scheme. The gospel is free, but you're paying for the experience. Because these are the people that will not give you Isaiah 55. Come buy without money and without price. Freely you receive, freely give. But at the end of the day, no, you paying for that man or that woman's time and their experience. And you're crying and your tears and you're falling out and your deliverance and your prophecy. You paying for all of that. And that's what they fly in for, to give you an experience. But at the end of the day, let me ask you this. Is God broke? Does God really need your money? Nah, he don't. Because money is a material thing. But when it comes to God, it should just be about your faith. And you shouldn't have to buy your father. But you praying that these men of God will come through. It's prostitution. Peace.